This video takes a look at the nonparametric tests that are available in the SPC for Excel software. These are tests when you can't assume you have a normal distribution. Many of the hypothesis tests are based on the assumption you have a normal distribution. Nonparametric tests are distribution-free tests. We have four in the SPC for Excel software. The one sample sign test, the one sample Wilcoxon sign rank test, the Mann-Whitney test for two samples, Kruskal-Wallis test for multiple samples. Let's take a look at these tests in the SPC for Excel software. The software contains two one-sample tests, the one-sample sign test and the one-sample Wilcoxon signed rank test, which is probably the better test of the two. But we're going to go ahead and just take a look at how you use these two tests. They're very similar. For example, we have a thermostat that we use in an electrical device. It's supposed to have a design setting of 200 degrees Fahrenheit. We'd like to know if that is true. So we go out and sample 10 thermostats and measure their design temperatures or their set temperatures, and there are the results: 202.2, 200.5, 198, 201.3. But you enter your data into an Excel spreadsheet, as we've shown here, and then you select the data. And what you'll find with nonparametric tests is that they deal with the median, not the average, because you're dealing with a distribution-free assumption. So you select your data, go to the SPC for Excel toolbar, and nonparametric. Select that, and you come up, and we're going to select the one sample sign test. In this case, we select OK. And what you do is you get your data. It doesn't include the headings. The variable is assumed to be in the cell above the data. Our alpha number for our confidence interval is 0.05, or 95%. Specified mean, we said we had to have 200 for our median. Here's our type of test. Is it two-sided, lower one-sided, or upper one-sided? We're going to keep with the two-sided, and we have the option to include the confidence interval, which we'll select. We also have some output options here. We can put the results here on this worksheet or on the new worksheet. We'll go with the new worksheet and select OK. And when you do that, you get your results. It comes out with the sign test for settings, what it is, and then you'll have the null hypothesis, which is that our median is equal to our specified, which is 200, or that it's not equal. And then here's the data, and the sign test deals with numbers that are above or below that specified setting or equal to, and it calculates eventually a p-value. And if this p-value is less than 0.05, then we assume that there is a difference between the design setting and the actual results. But this p-value is 0.1094, so the null hypothesis is not rejected. We assume that the median of these 10 is equal to the specified median of 200. And here are the confidence intervals down here. With the nonparametric, is not going to be exact. The software gets as close to as you can. They have 97.85% and one at 89.06%. But you can see at that level, at 0.10, there is a possibility that the design setting is not equal to the 200. Now, we can also run that with the Wilcoxon signed rank test. And we do the same thing: select the data, go to nonparametric, and select the one sample Wilcoxon signed rank test, OK, and we get a very similar input box. We enter our specified median. Everything else will keep the same. Select OK, and we get the same type of output where we have our null hypothesis and the alternate hypothesis, and the results come out. Interesting though, with this Wilcoxon signed rank test, the p-value comes out as 0.048. It's less than 0.05, and so we say there's evidence that the median does not equal 200. Software has a couple techniques to handle more than one sample. For example, one is the two-sample Mann-Whitney test. Suppose we were considering the failure times of 18 capacitors. We have 8 that were tested under normal operating conditions. This is our control group here, normal. And then we have 10 that were tested under thermally stressed conditions, and that's our stress group. And we enter the results. So here's the ones tested under normal conditions, and here are the ones that are tested under the stress conditions. And we want to know if there's a difference in the results, or the median of those under normal and those under stress. So what we do is we select our data as usual, go to the SPC for Excel ribbon, go to nonparametric, and we're going to select Mann-Whitney test for two samples. And it comes up and it gives us the range for method A that we've selected, the normal, and then we have method B, and then we have the title for method B. We selected our default alpha of 0.05. We're going to do a two-sided test, and again we're going to keep the output on the new worksheet. We select OK, and this brings out our results. And again, we have the null hypothesis that the two medians are equal. The alternate is that they're not equal. And here are all the results. And we have the number of plus differences, number of zero differences, and number of minus differences. Calculate alpha, z value. But here's the one that's key again, the p-value. Since it's greater than 0.05, we say there's no evidence that the two medians are not equal. We also have the Kruskal-Wallis technique to handle multiple samples. For example, suppose we have four different teaching methods, the case method, formula, equation method, and unitary analysis method, and we want to see if there's a difference in test scores that we got based on these teaching methods. So we have our data for each of the methods, and we simply select all that data along with the headings in this case, select nonparametric, and we select the Kruskal-Wallis test for multiple samples. Select OK. And then we have simply, here's the data we've entered. Has to be based in this analysis where you're in columns, and our alpha value of 0.05, when we select OK, and we have our results come out. And in this case, we have just the data reprinted, then we have the median, then we have some terms, rank sum, count, and the average rank, our alpha value, and something called the KW statistics, as well as our p-value. And you can see the p-value is less than 0.05, which means there is a difference in the teaching methods, and in this case, so we conclude there's evidence that there are differences. Then we go through a pairwise conversion where we take a look to see which ones are different. And we can see that the case method is different than the unitary analysis method, as well as the formula method is different than the unitary analysis method. So these are the techniques that we have for nonparametric testing in the SPC for Excel program. Again, there are four of them, and you use these when you have information that says your data is not normally distributed and you can't use some of those hypothesis testing. But thanks for taking time to watch the video.